So Darien was born in 2015 and he was diagnosed in 2018. I did not know any symptoms because I didn't know about autism. My husband alerted me to the fact that he wasn't responding to his name. He was walking on tippy toes. He was in his own world. But being my first child, I still didn't know that there was anything wrong. So I went to the pediatrician for something completely unrelated to autism. I made an appointment because there was a little mark on his neck and the pediatrician said, I'm not concerned about that. I'm concerned about your son. And that's the day he diagnosed him with autism. And I was okay about it because I didn't know what autism was. I went home and I read about what autism was and I read and I read and I cried and I was lost. So I did some biomed before I went into stem cells. I did biomed, we did a lot of ABA therapy, speech therapy, occupational therapy. Nothing seemed to work because he was in his own world. He couldn't sit down for more than 5 minutes for therapy. So my husband, I didn't know anything about stem cells, but my husband knew about stem cells. And he told me that we're not going to help my son in Australia. You need to go overseas and you need to research on stem cells. My first treatment, or Darien's first treatment, was in October 2019. And I went with Beike, Biotech. The reason for that is I did extensive research on a few clinics around the world, including Beike, and I was impressed with their technology, and they had been a company that had been established since 2005 and won some blood bank awards. So I also spoke to a few mums that had been both to other clinics around the world and also Beike. I located these mums from Australia. And I spoke to them on the phone because I initially thought everything was a scam unless I speak to mums on the phone with Australian accents. So I got in contact with about six or seven, and they two had gone to Beike and the others had gone elsewhere. I was impressed with the gains that the two mothers told me about, and being 9 to 10 hours from Australia, Sydney, and also with the great gains with their technology, with the number of stems that they had, including other therapies that they offered, we decided to go to Bangkok. For our first treatment, October 2019, before arriving to Beike, Bangkok, my son was in his own world. He didn't respond to his name. He did not interact with me. He did not interact with anyone. He would scream all day. And I literally mean, he was known from the neighbors as the boy that screamed, but they didn't know about his diagnosis. So having a young child as well, Darien couldn't be in the same room as his brother. So I have no family support in Australia. So I was in one room with Darien screaming for his brother not to be next to him. And then when I'd go to his brother, which was 3 years old at the time, crying for his mum, Darien would be screaming for me too. So I didn't know which child to choose, which was really hard. So I was so desperate to go. When we got to the treatment, I actually enjoyed the fact that my child was taken care of, his food was taken care of. He did therapy, which gave me some time out as well. He did occupational therapy, acupuncture, TMS, hydrotherapy, all therapies included. It was actually a really pleasant experience for all of us. Darien stopped screaming about the second week when we went there, and I thought it was due to the fact that he's away from his brother or he's on holidays kind of thing. But when we got off the plane in Sydney, the boy stopped screaming, period. And that was my main, that was a big gain for me, because my life was horrible with my son screaming all day. And so they were the first steps of, wow, is this treatment really working? Also with Darien, what I noticed as well with the first treatment was Darien was awake from 3 o'clock to 6 o'clock every night, and we would be, either me and my husband would be patting him for 3 hours. from 3 to 6 a.m. and then I'd have to get up at 6:30 for my other child after putting him to sleep. He would be awake 3 hours, no fail, every night. And that happened for a period of 2 years. It was exhausting. As soon as we got back, he still was waking up at night, but gradually it reduced to 1 hour. And then after 4 or 5 months, he has been sleeping overnight ever since. Also, eye contact improved a little. The second treatment was in February 2022, unfortunately, because of the pandemic. And that was actually horrible for me, just waiting and waiting for the borders to open because the first treatment was so successful. With the second treatment, the eye contact improved a lot more. He looks into your eyes now. He follows instructions. He became a little bit, definitely more social. A few mums that swimming tell me that, oh wow, he's so social because he goes and, you know, he'll kiss a little girl on the cheek or he'll want to play with neuro kids. But the problem is that because of his limited language or language, they don't play with him, but he tries. Comprehension wise, he improved as well. With the third treatment, for me, was the big one was socialization. As soon as we got off the plane, I think a couple of months, as soon as we got off the plane, my other son's friends came over and they all started jumping on the trampoline and he joined them. And we were like, oh wow. So the socialization improved a lot. He would swing kids at school in the playground. And the biggest one for me was the number two in the toilet. I tried previously to get him to poo in the toilet. I think it was treatment two, but it was so exhausting that he'd sit on the toilet for ages and do nothing, just be upset. So I gave up on number twos. I think it was 8 months after the third treatment that he decided that he doesn't want to poo anymore in the nappies, and he actually sat on the toilet and started pooing from then. And he's never done a poo in his nappy ever again because he doesn't wear one. So he's fully toilet trained after the third treatment. This is a child with a severe diagnosis, level 3, global development delay. And he does now, you know, he has ADHD as well. He's not on any medication. I think the stem cells have definitely helped him out there. Going to do stem cell therapy 3 times with Beike, I enjoyed this experience because my son got, the hotel was nice. We ended up staying in an apartment where I can cook sometimes for him. Also the therapies as well, that helped a lot. That helped him, you know, do something with his day instead of just get stem cells, go home. And it saved me doing any therapy in the hotel. Fourth treatment, I'm in Shenzhen, China today. Not what I expected. It's actually a bit better than I expected. Just overall, coming into Shenzhen, China, I didn't expect it to be such a beautiful modern city, for one. Also, the treatment of the doctors and the nurses here, I would say, is really good. The first day we were here, Darien was crying because the nurses had their uniforms on, and they actually took their uniforms off and were performing the procedure without uniforms just to make my son a bit more comfortable. Also, while we did do spinal here, Darien was down for 15 minutes only and he woke up fresh and he was quite happy for the rest of the day. So I really actually enjoy the experience here in China. I decided to fly into Hong Kong instead of directly to Shenzhen. And one of the reasons is we like to fly with Qantas and I like to have a look around Hong Kong as well. It only took about 40 minutes, I think, with the van that Beike picked us up. We went through customs and then directly to our hotel. The next day we had a free day so Darien can relax, and then Monday we started treatment. So far, I'm really happy with China. So with the treatment, I'm here for 14 days because I chose the 340 million. Stem cell amount, and included in that I decided to do FMT for reasons I'll go down that path, and nerve growth factor. With FMT, my son is constipated and has been since he was 3 or 2.5, and he needs to take laxatives, natural, but they're laxatives every day so he can go to the toilet. So I needed to take the FMT route. I've worked with naturopaths, nutritionists, everyone, and they still can't solve that problem. So I decided I will be doing FMT. So out of the 14 days that I'm here, it's only 4 days in the hospital. So it's a bit of a holiday for us because we don't go on holidays due to stem cell treatment. So having 10 days free with me and Darien, I get to spend a lot of time with him. So with the hospital, the first day Darien did have spinal and he was only down for 10 to 15 minutes. So the doctor did the spinal and the IV at the same time. And then he laid down in bed for a couple of hours. Day two, I've only done 2 spinals because that's all I wanted. I didn't want to do any more because previously my son has had a lot of stem cell treatments with spinal. This week we're doing IV, and by my surprise, I didn't give him any sedation today and he did so well. Got given the option to do HBOT chamber 3 times in the 2 weeks I'm here. That's located at the Beike building. So I took that option, and it's actually a really nice chamber where you go in and the child doesn't feel claustrophobic because it's like a little big cubby house. So they take the iPhone there and I go in with him. With FMT, surprisingly, I'm not sure, but I haven't given my son laxatives since I arrived in Shenzhen, which was the 16th or 17th of September. I didn't give him laxatives from the 17th. Today is the 26th of September, and he has had no laxatives and he's pooing daily. And we've had 3 FMT treatments. So I don't know whether that is just a fluke or it's actually working already. I know how hard it is with the special needs child, and I'm so glad that my mind isn't in that space where I only do traditional therapies, what I've been told to do by Western medicine. I'm just really glad, well, it wasn't working for us, so that's why I had to go to other avenues, and I'm just glad that this option is available for our kids, because there's not much out there for our kids, I believe, to heal them besides stem cell therapy. I don't think my child will ever be neurotypical, and that's who he is and that's how he's born with ASD. But if he can, you know, go on in life and be an independent man, that's all I ask for. Effect from this treatment is, I don't know, to be honest, but I know that every treatment I have, he has gains. I would love, obviously, more words, speech. I would love that. But at the same token, I want his brain to work. So if he doesn't have the voice, at least he can communicate, which he does, to me via a device, lamp. He also is at school now learning how to type because his handwriting's not the best. So I decided that the way of the world is through computers. So he's now typing and he's pretty good at that to communicate. So what am I hoping for? Just improvements in general. Each time I come with Beike and get him stem cells, he's improving. Otherwise, I wouldn't put my child through, or my whole family through, yearly treatments if I didn't see any benefit. So with any mum with an ASD 3 level child that, you know, is not sleeping, or the child is throwing tantrums, screaming, there is hope. For me, stem cell is the only hope. I've tried other things like MERT therapy, homeopathy, and I still follow that nutrition, but this is the only one that seems to work for my son. We go out to restaurants, he's patient, he doesn't scream, he waits for his meal. He also, actually I forgot to mention, after the first round of stem cell, he started reading, which he got into a mild to moderate special needs school, not a severe school, and he was diagnosed severe. So he's doing really well at school. And yeah, and he's sleeping through the night. He plays with his brother. He loves interacting with me. He looks into my eyes. He's very affectionate and a loving little boy. And hope this treatment gives me more.